Hello, dear viewers, and welcome to a new episode of Games and Names. Our sport for this episode is American football, and our star guest is American football player Omar Mandour. So let's get to know more about the sport and about Mandour in the upcoming minutes of Games and Names. December 13th, 2014 was the beginning of a new era of American football in Egypt when Egypt hosted the first African championship to qualify the winner to the American Football World Cup. The game was in the GUC field with more than 2,000 cheering for their national team. People, Abdurrahman Hafiz, Ali Rafiq and Amr Hibbo. EFAF currently has 8 affiliated teams with more than 800 registered individuals. The teams are the Cairo Bears, the GUC Eagles, the Cairo Hellhounds, the MSA Tigers, the AUC Titans, the Cairo Wolves, the Cairo Warriors, and the Gezira Thunder. EFAF is a socially responsible organization seeking the expansion, popularization, and development of American football in Egypt in both its tackle and flag formats. Faced with challenges through the introducing of the culture, ethics, and values of the sport, a complete systematic approach was the foundation of the vision, offering constructive training programs and competitions for youth as well as seasoned athletes. A football academy for all age groups was set up as a pillar for learning the basics of American football and therefore evolve the knowledge of the sport. Coaching and referees clinics hosted by experienced football individuals and experts to ensure proper education on all levels and consistency of performance throughout activities. What started at the end of 2006 with a meeting among friends progressed to 4 different teams being sponsored by Wadi Digla Sporting Clubs in 2010 and now has evolved to EFAF. EFAF was inaugurated in mid-2014 and now bolsters 8 different teams throughout Cairo and Giza. Egyptian football's true start was on May 8, 2014, when the International Federation of American Football, the IFAF, recognized football in Egypt by the attendance of the vice chair of IFAF Asia for the first fully equipped match in Egypt between the GUC Eagles and the Cairo Sharks. This visit was established to reckon the fact that Egypt will be an officially accepted member of the IFAF, which in turn would mean that the national team that is to be chosen will be granted international status and the ability to compete in international events. December 13th, 2014 was the beginning of a new era of American football in Egypt when Egypt hosted the first African championship to qualify the winner to the American Football World Cup. The game was in the GUC field with more than 2,000 cheering for their national team.
My name is Omar Mandour. I'm an American football player. In about September, it will become my 6th year playing this game. I started playing this game when I was 16. I'm now 22. It's been a long journey. I've obviously had to deal with a lot of injuries, a lot of heartbreaks in terms of losing games or losing seasons where we felt like we should have won. And I ended up playing both in Canada and in the USA, but mainly I've been playing here in Egypt. The main competitions that I've taken part in are mainly in Egypt. However, during my stint in Canada, I played against some of the top schools in the USA. So I graduated high school, and from then on, I went on to Canada. I was recruited to play there for 1 season. And all our games were played across the USA, so every weekend we'd be traveling to a different state, different city, playing a different team in a different high school. And that was definitely an eye-opening experience for me. I got to see the game, how it was played in its own national country, rather than just seeing it for what it is in Egypt. So for me that was a big opportunity for me to learn and to actually see the game for what it should be. basically, how the teams are split up, we're split up into three different sets of teams. So we have the offense, the defense, and the special teams. The offense, their goal is to take possession of the ball, move it down the field, and score points, score a touchdown by passing through the end zone, which is the final part of the field, final 10 yards of the field. Once you pass that with the possession of the ball, then you score a touchdown, and then you have an opportunity either to score one extra point by kicking it through the field goal, or scoring 2 points by running the ball through the end zone once again. The defense, their main job is to stop the offense from gaining yards and from scoring against their team. Special teams, they go onto the field for either when they're kicking off, returning a kick, so at the start of a game, or once a touchdown has been scored, as well as field goals. So they'll line up, pin the ball on the ground, and we'll have a kicker kick the ball and see if it's a field goal attempt, you can score 3 points. But if it's an extra point after a touchdown, that's only worth 1 point. The key difference between the women's league and the men's league is the men's league is obviously full tackle, full speed, whereas for the women's league, there's absolutely no tackling. They're played with flags on their waist. Their flags are pulled, and once the flag that flag is pulled, that counts as a tackle. Interestingly enough, I did start off by playing rugby. I lived in Kenya for about 4 years, and I fell in love with rugby. But once I moved back to Egypt, I found it hard to find a good place to play rugby. And it was just by chance, when I was scrolling through Facebook, I found a sponsored message saying, oh, there's tryouts for the Cairo Bears, American football team, and it was right next to my house. So I couldn't say no to the opportunity. But the main difference in terms of the actual sport itself, so for rugby, you wear absolutely no equipment. The only thing you wear is a mouth guard, and that's it. The aim of the game is you're still trying to get to the end zone, but with rugby, you have to touch the floor with the ball, and you're only allowed to pass backwards. Whereas for American football, you're trying to gain yards by throwing the ball forwards and seeing if one of your receivers can catch the ball, get you your yards, and even potentially score you a touchdown. We'll be right back. A common misconception that people look at American football players with is that they feel like they need to be big, strong, and muscular, and that's the only importance that that your body has in the game. But in all honesty and in all truth, you can play this game with any body type. There is a position for every single body type. Whether you're small and skinny but you're fast, you'll have a position for you. Whether you're big and you're strong, there's a position for you. So you can play the game with absolutely any body type, but the main thing that you need to make sure is strong is your mind. Because you're going full speed into someone, they're coming at you full speed. You need to make sure that you're confident in yourself, confident in your ability, that I'm gonna beat this person that's coming at me and trying to get that ball from me and trying to tackle me and bring me to the ground. So locally, we have the ENFL, which is run and organized by EFAF, which is EFF, the Egyptian Federation of American Football. So it's an annual event. This year we're running our 8th season. And yeah, this is basically what all players look forward to at the end of months of practice. This is what every player is waiting for. On an international level, there isn't much of an international presence between countries. However, obviously the biggest American Football League is the National Football League in America. That's been going on for years, decades. And that's where the game started. In America, that's the home of the game. And we're just trying to bring it to Egypt and to other countries in the region. Our main focus to spread the game in Egypt as of now is social media. That's how we gain most of our audience. Every team is responsible for their own team's social media, as well as the Egyptian Federation running its own social media campaigns, trying to promote the game in its own way. But I do feel like we do still have a long way to go, where we need to have equipment being brought in to us, because right now the game is completely self-funded by the players. Players are paying fees on a monthly basis to make sure that we have a place to practice. We have enough money to either bring foreign players or foreign coaches in. So it's completely self-funded now. So we would like to see some funding where some of that load is taken off of the players, and we have more access to either equipment, better training fields, better fields to play on when we do actually play our actual league. And other than that, we can also try and get our games to be broadcast live on TV. That will bring it to a much wider audience across Egypt and across the region, showing that this game is important enough to be on TV, and it's not just a hobby that, you know, a few men and a few women like to play on the weekend. Because it's a lot more than that. It's a very competitive league, both for the women and the men. And I think it deserves to be in the spotlight. How the league is run, we start off running it as if it's just a normal football league. So you're trying to score points, win games, and the top two teams then go on to play in the final, and the winner of that final gets to be the championship holder for that season. I would say the top two teams right now in the league are the GUC Eagles and the Cairo Hellhounds. So the GUC Eagles are basically, they pretty much started the game in Egypt. They were one of the first teams to play and first teams to take it seriously. So initially they started off with a lot more experience over every other team. So they had a streak where they were winning, I believe they won five championships. And the Cairo Hellhounds have won the past two, I believe. So yeah, competition is starting to rise. The gap between teams is starting to decrease. So we're starting to see a higher level of competition between players and between teams. And as before, where you'd go into season saying, okay, so this team is going to win, this team is going to be the best. From the past couple of years, now it's more of, we're going in and we're going to see which team comes on top, because we don't know which team is going to be the best team this season, because the level of competition has become much, much tighter.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalist.
What I hope to see for the game in the future is that it grows not just in Egypt but also in the region. It started to grow more internationally, whereas before it was just in the USA and that was where it was mainly at. So now we're starting to see countries like Germany, Morocco, Cameroon, Japan, the UK, all sorts of different countries taking part in the sport, trying to give it the love that it deserves. because this is a sport that doesn't just challenge you physically, it also challenges you mentally more than anything, honestly. So having this game grow and getting the spotlight that it deserves is everything that I'd want to see for this game.